that we actually really want to do, because that one time in fifth grade, Sally told you that your sweater was ugly, so you thought that meant that you had bad fashion. If you had bad fashion, you would want to be your friend. So now you're 40 and you're an engineer. That's how it happens. And the more that we're aware of these little voices in our minds, the more that we can be like, you know what, little self? I'm not you anymore, and I got this. And a lot of times, that comes with guilt. How many of you in here, other than today, I'm super proud of you all for choosing to be here and doing something for yourself, but how many of you in here feel guilty when you have to say no to not doing something for somebody else? Yeah.
You guys
are,
what are you doing? Tell us.
Give love and receive love unless we're filling our own cup up. you hate being. No one's gonna knock on your door and do that. And the majority of the time we wait, and we wait, and we wait to do the things to light us up, to make me cry, to get permission from somebody else to do the things that we wanna do. And so today I'm here to give you permission, to give you an order to go do something that lights you up. Not your husband, not your kids, not your friends, not your mom, not your job, you up. And some of you might be thinking, well, I know hashtag solo moments now are usually bubble baths, and I hate bubble baths. They don't have to be bubble baths. It can be watching that Netflix show for 5 hours, and you're like, you know what? I'm in the mood to watch TV and not socialize today. That's okay. You can never not be in action. When you tell somebody, no, thank you so much for inviting me, I'll see you next time, you don't need to feel guilty for watching your show on Netflix, because you're doing something. And you're connecting with yourself and rejuvenating your body. It can be beating up your pillow and imagining that your boss's face is on it because he's ticked you off for the 19th time. Instead of holding it in, you get to allow yourself to let these emotions out. It can be going for a 5-hour hike. I don't care what it is, as long as it lights you up, you have permission to do that. And I'm gonna challenge all of you, other than today, to do it at least once this week. At least once, especially when it comes to Valentine's Day. Even if you're in a relationship, single or not, do something on Valentine's Day to have a mother effing soul ball for you, okay? And really quick for the singles, maybe I already talked about this, about the acronym SAD.
No.
Okay. 2 years ago, I was like, what is going on Facebook? Everybody's like, it's Valentine's Day. It's SAD. It's sad. I'm like, what is this? Single Awareness Day. Come on. No, this is for all of us. It is now Soul and Amazing AF Day. So you get to do something for you. So one, do something that lights you up. Two, I want you to do something for a stranger. Because when you give love, you get love, right? Like energy attracts like energy. You want to attract more of that in your life, you gotta give it. And this can be something as small as leaving a note on somebody's car. Hey, you're a beautiful soul, I hope you have an awesome day. It can be giving a stranger a compliment. It can be paying for somebody's coffee in line, whatever it is. Do something for somebody else. I'm gonna give you 4 tasks, okay? I also want you to take responsibility of something. And I know a lot of us are like, oh my God, responsibility, no! Like, it's so much easier to blame that person and that person and that thing. Responsibility, taking responsibility does not mean like shoving yourself in a corner and beating yourself up and telling yourself that you're this horrible person. Responsibility is actually being like, you know what?